There's a couple of reasons why you may be here and why, again, you are in a traditional attire. I mean, a kurta, I never wore this before. It's new, what it will buy. Hopefully, I can fit it. And if you see, those who have attended our first launch in 2017, you have noticed the same background. Have you all seen the same background of my introduction? With the guy, the two kids with the Malaysian flag. There's a couple of reasons as well why the same background I'm using. Number one, I think I look younger in the picture.
No, I don't look younger.
Below 40 in that picture. Right? And second, is the spirit of being a Malaysian first and Indian second. Right? I think all of us are part Malaysian. So we wanted to be in line with the trend of this month. And then last month, the Merdeka Day and the Malaysian Day. So we made the entire look and feel of the people, of the setup. You'll be surprised at the food later. It's all going to be Malaysianized. Right. And again, Selamat Hari Merdeka. Selamat Hari Malaysia. Come back to Nokia. What a journey. Since 2017, our first entrance back into the mobile industry, it has been an exciting journey for us, HMD Global, and also Nokia Mobile, our partners, AVEX Corporation. A very interesting journey in the crowded space of mobile handsets, right? We went out there, we fought hard, went against the top names of mobile brand. Nokia is the top HMD Malaysia team and our partner in media. And of course, the media and the fans, number one, supporting us with constructive feedback, you know, because of the devices that we bring in, it's not up to certain mark and so on. So that gives us an avenue to keep improving in our devices. And if you see, it's never easy. It's never an easy task for a manufacturer to go out there and start building up devices which is, you know, well received by every aspect of consumers. And today, after 2+ years, we have launched 17 smartphones into the market, from the entry level right up to the top mid-range level. And we had a bit of an introduction of a flagship level, but we're still trying to find the right formula, what could be a killer flagship, right? At the same time, while introducing the smartphones, we're not forgetting, the feature phone markets in Malaysia are pretty much big, and Nokia is basically a hands-down leader in that space, and we continue building up feature phone, upgrading our existing portfolio, and we also have fun by bringing back the Nokia original series with some twist behind it, right? And again, as I said, it's never an easy task. But as what Nadia said, as what all of us feel, Nokia smartphone, it just keeps getting better. And the reason why I say that, and that's basically our value proposition and our promise. In 2017, when we came up on the stage and reintroduced the arrival of Nokia smartphone, we made a promise. What we said is, we will ensure your Nokia smartphones keeps getting better. And we have done that in a record time, right? A lot of brands out there takes 16 to 18 months to upgrade their OS of their phone, and some of them also fail to deliver the security updates that are needed behind the phone. But for Nokia smartphones, if you have noticed, the phones that we have launched in 2017, today, even the Nokia 1 today runs on Android. And that makes the phone keeps getting better. Right? 2017 is on Prime today. If you take a comparison for any other brands, I'm not mentioning names, if you take any other brands at that range, at that price point, are still living in the past. Our Nokia 3 has followed the trend, and today they are on Android 5. And recently we have extended the monthly security update period to another year. So they get 4 years of monthly security updates. Right? So, that is basically what we believe in our Nokia smartphones. We make sure the phone stays fresh for you and brings you the latest innovation from Google. And we continue delivering the message to all our new phones as well. And that's, again, our value proposition in Nokia smartphones. It's very, very important. I'll let you know why it's important. A few things. Why is OS upgrade is important in your devices? A lot of consumers tend to not pay attention to this. But we are not stopping. We are keep on delivering and explaining to them why OS updates are very important to your devices. Right? In every single communication from Nokia, you see we are mentioning this aspect. There will be a time where everybody starts speaking this language. I need an OS update. I need an OS update. Why my phone is not upgraded to Android 9? Why my phone is not upgraded to Android 10 in the future? Right? So, upgrading OS gives you a peace of mind. It makes the phone work better because the OS optimizes all sort of application that you have in your phone. It gives your battery longer life because the processing speed all are optimized because of the new OS. It gives you a data security behind it. Again, consumers today are taking a step back, not thinking data security is important. Now, I'm not saying all consumers, a majority of them, still living a step behind saying, okay, I'm fine, I think my data is protected. But if you don't get monthly security update from the OS owner, which is Google, who are continuously building up patches to ensure your phone is highly secure from malware, spyware, or hacks, or any of those, right? It's very important to have OS upgrade. And the OS upgrade, what will it enhance in your device? Right? It enhances every single part of your device. The battery life, the internal memory, the camera, potentially you'll have a new UI of the camera, right? And the processor. You're probably having, you know, I'm hearing a lot of comments out there, why are we using the old chipset? You know, why? You see, chipsets are nevermore, right? This is my opinion. Chipsets are nevermore. Chipsets are built according to the segment of the device. Chipsets are built according to the functionality of the devices, right? When you have continuous upgrades on your device in terms of OS, the chipset works perfectly fine, right? It's all about the segment and the category of the devices that we see. And being a Nokia smartphone, you pay attention to very, very much details. The reason why you see build quality is crossed. Upgrading OS, getting a monthly security update, doesn't translate your plastic phone to a metal phone, right? So that's why it doesn't enhance your build quality, but it enhances every single part of your device. And that's what we preach. I makan, it gets better. I tido, it gets better. Right? We preach that in every single aspect of our devices in our Nokia smartphone. Right? And the value proposition that we continue bringing out to the market, preaching since 2017, finally, we got an endorsement from a global research agency, counterpart. Thanks for media. I'm very proud. At least now, Nokia is ranked number one in the world to bring in the security and OS upgrades to devices. consistently living up to our promises. We are not letting that go. However it is, we are living up to these promises to bring monthly security updates and OS upgrades to everybody in Nokia smartphone. User experience is definitely key for us. Okay? So we promise a very simplified user experience in your device. We don't have another layer of a Google OS in your device. Right? If you take a look at Nokia phones, it's again, we are going back to the past. Ease of use of Nokia smartphones. Right? And this has been validated by Counterpoint. We are number one in global in terms of OS upgrade. So in detail, if you look at it, nearly 96% of our smartphones are already on the latest OS. Those have been launched in 2017. Why 96%? Some of it are China-specific variants and so on. They don't get because they have a different OS and so on. But majority of the global release, including the Malaysia Nokia smartphones, we are already on the latest OS. What's the latest OS today? Pi.